please welcome our host for tonight's program, Mr. David Celdran.
Good evening to all of you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines 2022 Awards Night. I hope you're all doing very well. You know, it's been a very long time since I've seen a ballroom this full. The last time we were able to stage this event was way back in 2019. It seems such a long time ago, doesn't it? Well, I think now we're all extremely lucky, and I should say extremely blessed to be able to celebrate this evening together in face-to-face and, of course, in person. So let's give ourselves a big round of applause because we are Undaunted and we are Unstoppable. Speaking of which, Undaunted and Unstoppable celebrates, that's our theme, by the way, for the year, celebrates visionary entrepreneurs who leverage on new ideas and new technologies to challenge old paradigms and seize opportunities to develop sustainable enterprises that have the potential to transform industries and support economic development, and I might add, transform societies. Now, guided by their relentless determination and purpose, and motivated by their aspirations, these unstoppable and undaunted Filipino entrepreneurs work with foresight, with courage, and compassion to empower communities and uplift our nation. Ladies and gentlemen, in the search for this year's most outstanding Filipino entrepreneurs, as you all know, the judging phase is the most critical component of this year-long search. Nominations underwent a rigorous, very rigorous screening process using Entrepreneur of the Year global standards. That's how high our standards are here. It is our honor to present to you the five individuals who meticulously vetted this year's winners.
The year 2022 marks the return of the prestigious Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines Awards. Now in its 14th year of recognizing outstanding individuals that help make up the country's backbone. Based on the continuous stream of nominations drawn from various sectors and industries across the country, the allure of being named the next Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines has only intensified as the years have passed. As with previous years, the nominees went through a rigorous screening and evaluation process that utilizes a stringent financial data ranking system developed for and used by all countries participating in the Entrepreneur of the Year program. The criteria has been developed to align with EY's purpose of building a better working world. By celebrating entrepreneurs who are truly creating long-term value, EY is able to build strong relationships with entrepreneurs who align with our values and are making the world a better place. This year's distinguished panel of judges is chaired by Asian Institute of Management Dean and CEO, Dr. Ji Kyong Kang.
There are variety of industries, sectors, the background of entrepreneurs being represented. And I always like to see entrepreneurs coming from perhaps not very privileged family background or not having sort of top-notch educational background, because I think in some ways that gives more inspiring, encouraging stories to people who are from underprivileged sectors.
Joining the judging panel this year is a distinguished alumni of the EOYP program, 2019 Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines, Benjamin Yao.
We're looking for the best example, the best model. So that's very important. This will multiply it. The more EY is known and the stories, this will encourage more, will inspire also future entrepreneurs.
The theme for 2022 is Undaunted, Unstoppable. Quite a fitting theme for this year's crop of finalists, who, aside from navigating their respective businesses through the normal challenges brought about by a rapidly changing environment, have also had to deal with the unique threats posed by the COVID-19 pandemic.
These days where there is rapid development of digital technology, increasing globalization, where borders are becoming more porous. Supply chains are cutting across borders. There is increasing mobility of labor. It's important for one to think globally or regionally, take advantage of what globalization can offer. And of course, being mindful of local nuances as well.
Well, during the pandemic, some of the businesses were able to adapt and change their practices so that they could keep their employees, they could keep their businesses running. That's very good. It shows that the entrepreneurs who have this business have agility, adaptability to the situation. It's very fascinating. In fact, I saw some were able to take advantage of the situation and actually expand their businesses from being traditional businesses to the ones that are more technologically savvy.
Now, the pandemic, it brings out the best of entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs are catalysts. They look at the opportunities to be part of the solution. So they thrive on crisis. That's the nature of entrepreneurs.
Entrepreneurs play a vital role in a nation's economic development, and each of this year's 18 finalists have the capacity to inspire others.
Well, entrepreneurship is the backbone of the economy, because without entrepreneurship, then we will not be able to generate more jobs, especially in the countryside. Based on the background of our candidates today, I think they are really unstoppable. They want to conquer more territories. They want to produce related products and services. They are moving forward and really expanding to bigger and newer horizons.
Entrepreneurship is important anywhere in the world, but especially in countries like the Philippines. One is a developing country. Lots and lots of small businesses and family-owned businesses and so on and so forth. And acknowledging and celebrating success of entrepreneurs is absolutely critical. So I think it has contributed a lot. I know there are various entrepreneurship-related awards, but this one is especially prestigious and it means a lot. The people who have been nominated, as well as, of course, the winners.
Tonight, another entrepreneur from the crop of 18 finalists will rise above the others to become the country's top entrepreneur. Who will be the next Entrepreneur of the Year, Philippines?
Indeed, after a year, nearly a year of intensive screening, the search, as I said, was narrowed down to just 18 entrepreneurs from diverse industries, all of them extremely qualified to become our Entrepreneur of the Year, Philippines 2022. Inspiring visionaries, game-changing pioneers, and resilient market leaders, we present to you our finalists in the search for the Entrepreneur of the Year, Philippines 2022.
I am motivated by the freedom of creating a solution for the changing needs of the society. Money is a result of a successful solution that sustains the business. I am inspired by the never-ending search of providing my family with a better quality of life. At the beginning of 2020, we were closely monitoring the events happening in Wuhan, China. We saw how it will affect our business, our school and office canteens, and event catering. This was the challenge, bringing access to food during quarantine. As early as February 2020, we used digital media for orders and payments and converted our canteen personnel to handle deliveries so they will have continued livelihood. We pivoted and created frozen viand menu that is aligned with canteen pricing so we could be budget sustainable for customers. The early planning made the company the biggest frozen meals business in the Philippines. the majority of successful Filipino entrepreneurs did not start the business with lots of resources. In fact, the lack of it forced them to find creative means. And this should go hand in hand with hard work. The exciting part in business is no one has a monopoly on bright ideas. It is open to all. But what separates the successful entrepreneurs is they don't give up. The big opportunity may not be the initial plan you have in mind, but may come from insights you gain from the challenges you face along the way.
Round of applause for our first finalist this evening, Ricardo D'Abelardo Jr., the President and Chief Operating Officer of Artemis Plus Express Incorporated, also known as Kitchen City.
Ngo Kim Park, the founder of Equitable Bank, was an early inspiration to my growing up years. His work ethic resonated strongly with me. He was hardworking, humble, and easy to trust. And these qualities have inspired me to do the same as an entrepreneur. There have been too many disruptions to mention in my long life of being in business. But one that stands could be the Asian financial crisis of 1997. To survive, we initiated and implemented cost-cutting measures to control expenses and double time on sales and collection. This spirit will help any entrepreneur and any endeavor they may wish to seek. Filipino entrepreneurs are all naturally social entrepreneurs. It is built into our character and our culture as we Filipino have a strong natural kinship to our brothers and sisters in the community. Every Filipino has that desire to help our family and even our extended family. It is this strong family culture that makes us all social entrepreneurs. My message to future and could-be entrepreneurs. Put in the work. Hard work is the foundation of a successful entrepreneur. Be sincere. Customers and business partners will help you along the way as you earn their trust. Be humble. Learn to ask and when to ask for help or advice. With this, you can build on your career with these pillars. Because as with any building, you cannot build high if you do not have a strong foundation.
Roberto J. Chan, Chairman and CEO of Atlanta Industries Incorporated. Congratulations, sir.
An entrepreneur is like being an art painter in business. It allows me to create and mold my business to my vision and objective of what my company should be. This is what motivates me every day. I have five people who are influential to me in my life and business journey. The two renowned tech giants like Bill Gates and Michael Dell. My father, who influenced me to be a good and generous man. Mrs. Rosa Yu, my mentor. And lastly, my beautiful wife, Wilma, who has always been my guiding light. Every generation has its war. Our grandparents and parents have World War II. We have COVID pandemic and its quarantine lockdown. I realized at the onset that with everybody imprisoned in their homes, connecting people and businesses will be the key to the country's economic survival. And what is the primary catalyst for connecting people? It is technology. Fortunately for AMTI, we were ahead of the curve. As a result, we were able to deliver those much-needed equipments, solutions, and services to the essential industries such as BPO, healthcare, and financial sectors. We didn't only survive, we flourished during the COVID crisis. Unfortunately, the Philippine business ecosystem is not ideal or at par compared to our neighboring countries. It is indeed challenging to run a business with our country with so many obstacles. But this limited ecosystem has made Filipino entrepreneurs tough, resourceful, and resilient. And this challenging environment instills these traits that you don't learn from any business school. Please do not leave this country. Despite the many obstacles of doing business here, do not let being average in intellect, communications, and financial resources stop you from pursuing your dreams and ambition. So, follow your dreams.
Congratulations to Alex Santikua, President and CEO of AMTI Axit Micro Technologies Incorporated. Unfortunately, Mr. Kua could not join us tonight, so we'd like to call on Mr. Josefino Bong Paloma, the EVP for Technology, Sales, and Marketing of AMTI, to accept the award in behalf of Mr. Alexon Kua.
As an entrepreneur, I'm constantly motivated by the drive to succeed, not just for myself, but for my family, for the whole company, and by the rare privilege to push the boundaries of what a homegrown food company can achieve in the Philippines and beyond it. I'm only able to do this by being inspired on a daily basis by our hardworking staff, the lifeblood of our organization, by our steadfast partners who have stood by us and supported our growth through thick and thin, and most and above all, by God, without whom none of my nor Wildflower's success would be possible. As with most companies, the pandemic really came out of left field as a huge disruptor, not just to business, but to the world's way of living in general. Being a sit-down restaurant business at its core, Wildflower needed to adapt in a big way in the face of heavy restrictions on movements and especially dine-in service in order to survive. Thankfully, by maximizing our own existing assets, making strategic daily and long-term decisions, the organization has emerged from the pandemic as an even stronger business than it was entering it. Filipino entrepreneurs have an undeniable sense of grit and tenacity that you wouldn't normally see with those from other countries. I have witnessed firsthand just how challenging it is to successfully lead and manage a business in the Philippines. With enough perseverance and fortitude, any problem can be solved. Being an entrepreneur isn't easy, but by seeing the forest for the trees, remembering why you decided to do this in the first place, you will surprise yourself with the hurdles you are able to clear and the triumphs you are able to achieve. Lastly, and most importantly, believing in the power of God's grace will go a long way in empowering you through the toughest ordeals and the most crucial decisions.
Congratulations to Wildflower Cafe and Bakery Corporation's CEO and President, Ana Del Campo.
I became an entrepreneur because I felt that there were many unmet needs in the local beauty scene. The market was saturated by international brands, most of which were really not created for Filipinas. I wanted to prove that local brands could be just as good or even better than international brands in terms of quality, performance, and even packaging. For me, true fulfillment comes from being able to train young minds and create jobs that support families. These are the roles that I truly embrace. My ultimate mission is to create brands that are successful and sustainable, bringing pride and generating more jobs for more Filipinas. We were able to take the pandemic by the horns and remain profitable during the past 2 years. Many brands laid low and stopped innovating, but not us. BLK continued to drop new collections every 2 months. In 2021, even when mall traffic was low, we worked with Watsons to expand our footprint nationwide. We also approached several international resellers and are now available in the US, UK, Australia, Europe, and Asia. This kind of foresight puts us ahead of our competitors because we took a calculated risk early and we expect to reap the rewards and benefits moving forward. Filipino entrepreneurs have malasakit, or the heart to care for their employees, more than just looking at the numbers. This makes us stronger as heads of businesses, because when we treat employees like family, they become more passionate about giving their best to the company. Know the value of hard work. Make sure that your business has a sustainable growth plan and a healthy bottom line that can reinvest for future expansions. It's also crucial to find and invest in key talent, people and partners you can trust and who will complement your skills and support your vision. Always remember that every success entails hours and hours of hard work, failure, and teamwork. Lead by example. Put people first. You are an entrepreneur not just for yourself, but more importantly, for the people whose livelihoods depend on you. Make them your priority.
Jacqueline Jade Gutierrez, co-founder and chief executive officer of Beauty Refinery Incorporated, BLK Cosmetics.
As an entrepreneur, I'm motivated by the prospects of making an idea into a successful, sustainable, and socially beneficial reality. My inspiration is my family. In 1968, I assumed the management of a financially challenged Far East Motors Inc. and immediately set to work plugging all income leaks, enhancing sales force, focusing on collections, improving service, and striving for repeat business. By the late 70s until the mid 80s, we were able to build strong enough relationships with banks, lending partners, that we were able to undertake expansion projects. In the mid-1990s till 2019, Inteco collaborated with the principals of other dealers and other brands, revived the Philippine Automotive Association, or PAA, now known as Philippine Automotive Dealers Association, or PADA, and devised models of effective inventory management. When the pandemic hit, we suffered a major loss and did not record any sales. We continued to service the logistics requirements of the essential goods and services industry. Thanks to this, we are rebounding strong and expanding our business even further. I'm always amazed of how resilient Filipino entrepreneurs are in the face of adversity. They never lose their sense of humor. They are dedicated to their craft and possess boundless amounts of Bayanihan spirit. My advice to entrepreneurs would be to have passion, so you can arouse enthusiasm in others. Communicate and be transparent. Always have an optimistic attitude. Prepare for the unexpected and be ready to take action. And lastly, have an eye towards your legacy. You may guide others to follow your life through the example you gave.
Raymond G. Harina, President and Chief Executive Officer of Inteco, Group of Isuzu Dealerships.
Oftentimes, when you know that in your own little way, you help someone achieve a dream, a goal, or accomplish a task, big or small, it fills you with a sort of accomplishment. My greatest inspiration is my dad, Levy, or fondly LPL. Brick by brick, he built the foundations of a great legacy, the Laos Group of Companies. Losing him in 2019 was devastating. But with the support from my mom, family, and stakeholders in the company, I was able to gain the much needed strength in order to move forward. Taking over the handles of an established business is never a walkover, more so if the circumstance was abrupt. We had to ensure that business operations remained normal, assuring principals, creditors, and customers that life goes on. The family governance concept I introduced was well received by family members as an essential step in preparing the next generation. While the pandemic was a big disruption, it gave us time to retool, rethink, and reposition the company in the eventual rebooting of the economy. Resilience, the ability to smile and see a rainbow despite gloomy days. This happy and laid-back trait of the Filipino is translated into a passion and fearlessness in the Filipino entrepreneur. To my fellow entrepreneurs, let me borrow a line from a Disney movie: have courage and be kind. Find what works for you and believe in your dreams and vision. Know that someone up there has a mighty plan for all of us. We just need to believe, trust, and surrender. Business ventures may fail, but remember, in failure, there is an opportunity to rebuild.
Lisette A. Laos Velasco, the Chairman and CEO of Global Cars Philippines, Incorporated. Congratulations.
I started this company in 2013. After buying stocks in the companies of Elon Musk and then seeing how solar energy was underappreciated by the market at the time. The examples of other entrepreneurs showed me that even traditional industries are ripe for disruption. Based on the examples of companies in other markets, I initially thought the winning business model in solar was vertical integration, and more generally, being the most efficient operator. But then I learned that most of solar is ultimately a commodity business. And in the Philippines in particular, the value was most of all in securing the scarce resource of solar land. The key in this particular business is to be not the best, but the first. We changed our strategy towards collaborating with others on the other parts of the solar value chain, while sharpening our focus on project development, largely consolidating land, the part with the highest value. Entrepreneurship in the Philippines is held back compared to our Asian neighbors because of the structure of our economy that can be traced to our history. But when you look at how productive just a few million Filipinos are in America, you can see that Filipinos can achieve so much when planted in more fertile ground. Compared to our Asian neighbors, the Philippine economy is so underdeveloped, but so was every first world country just a few decades ago. And some entrepreneurs there may wish to have been around when those countries' economies were still being built. The bright side of being an entrepreneur in the Philippines today is that we have the opportunity to help build our country's economy in ways that entrepreneurs in already developed countries wish they had.
Our next finalist is Leandro Antonio Levisa, the founder, president, and chief executive officer of Solar Philippines Power Project Holdings Incorporated. Congratulations.
I am constantly motivated by the challenge of making best decisions that will benefit the company. My jobs give me a sense of higher purpose to be able to help improve the quality of life of my employees. I am also able to share and teach what I know. I love what I do, and I am passionate about creating value for the business and making a positive impact on the people I work with. I admire Steve Jobs because of his ability to spot talents and his willingness to go to uncharted markets. I am also a believer of Richard Branson, who once said, "To take care of your employees and they will take care of your business." During the Asian crisis, I founded the United Broiler Raisers Association, or UBRA, which lobbied for the interests of the broiler industry against the importation of chicken leg quarters and other government policies that are not beneficial to the industry. Later on, I realized that I could not depend solely on just one product. So I diversified into hog raising in 2001. And after 4 years, I ventured into meat retail by opening the first outlet of Fresh Option Meat Shop in Angeles City. Filipino entrepreneurs are known to be resilient. They are able to bounce back because they embrace challenges as an opportunity to innovate and improve their business processes. Allow me to share with you some pieces of advice. Enjoy what you're doing and be passionate. Don't be afraid to fail. Move on and bounce back stronger. Always keep learning new things. Be different. Effective differentiation will make your business stand out from the competitions.
Dr. Robert H. Law, CEO of RDF Feed, Livestock and Foods Incorporated. Our ninth finalist this evening.
Success is a compelling motivational factor for me, not money. I strongly feel that I have this chip on my shoulder, which constantly promotes an insatiable urge to prove myself to those close to me or deal with on a regular basis. I must admit that I'm not much of a people pleaser. So it's the people I'm familiar with, respect, and are dear to me who inspire me to always give the best of myself. The most serious disruption was the COVID-19 lockdown. We had to be resourceful and determined to survive. We also implemented a rotating schedule for our staff so we would not be forced to lay anyone off. A lot of lessons were learned during COVID-19. You just have to aggressively and creatively deal with it and never lose your faith and optimism. Fortunately, we live in an age where it has become irrelevant what your nationality, cultural background, or economic standing is, which is why we intended to export our ice cream upon starting. We never doubted that our quality was second to none, and we could compete with the much larger and more established ice cream companies, both in the Philippines and overseas. It should be understood that entrepreneurship is not for everyone, but there is no shame in being employed for as long as you are not lying, cheating, or fooling anyone. It may end up that you'll even be working much longer hours than the company boss. The rewards that will come, however, for a job well done, like the respect of colleagues and increased privileges, will truly be awesome.
Francisco Magsaysay, the President and Chief Executive Officer of Carmen's Best Dairy Products Incorporated.
I get my fulfillment from buying raw land, planning, developing master plant boutique communities, and turning over lots and houses and condo units to their new owners. My family stories inspire me. My grandfather started penniless and worked his way until he had his own small hardware store, while my father diversified into the steel business, which provided me the seed capital to go into realty development. During the pandemic, we strengthened our digital marketing efforts, starting with the creation of virtual tours for clients residing abroad and the complete overhaul of our websites. Through these efforts, our revenues increased and profits even doubled from 2019 to 2021. Filipino entrepreneurs are bold and optimistic because of their faith in God and in the future of the country. We Filipinos are innately innovative and creative in coming out with the best solutions, even in the worst of times. Never, ever give up. Find your passion in serving your customer. Go the extra mile. Wow your customers. Be thrifty. Be optimistic, even in the pandemic or economic crisis. Be daring to pursue your dream, your purpose. And lastly, never forget to give back to your employees, to the community, and to your country.
Jeffrey Nang, President and Chief Executive Officer of Cathay Land Incorporated.
As an entrepreneur, I have always been inspired by the thought that I could make a difference in the lives of people whom I have asked to join my business endeavor. Together with my co-shareholders and staff, we have changed the landscape of some of our cities, helping thousands of families in the process. I believe I have helped people improve their economic status and my clients achieve their dreams. The pandemic caused us to think ways to survive. Many of our clients suspended or slowed down construction activities, which forced us to farm out some of our project-based employees. The slow movement in collections also challenged our cash flows, which necessitated cuts in pay for all our employees, including ourselves. However, I am pleased to report that we have given back to them everything that we have taken. Through judicious fiscal management, we're able to meet our financial commitments. I think the creativity and resourcefulness of Filipino entrepreneurs are what distinguish them. As entrepreneurs, we empathize with our workers. We see them as part of our success. It's part of our acquired attitude of bayanihan. Follow your dream and make it happen. Stay focused on your vision and be clear with your intentions and ways to reach your goals. Keep your integrity intact. Heed your conscience. Do not be afraid to ask guidance from those who are way ahead of you. Continue to learn and hone your craft. Balance your time for your family, friends, community, and your health and well-being. Most of all, have faith and rely on someone up there, greater than yourself. And don't forget to give back some of the things that you were blessed with.
The Chairman and CEO of Metro Storage Corporation, Ibrahim Nuño.
My main driving force is to use innovation to bring about positive social change that will aid in the development of an effective transportation system in the Philippines. We founded ANCAS in response to the country's traffic crisis and how it impacts the government, small enterprises, regular workers, and students. We were able to improve the lives of our riders by professionalizing the motorcycle taxi sector. And I am motivated to go even further and provide the same support to the nation's 18 million motorcycle riders. The regulators did not really know what ANCAS was offering in the transportation sector. This is why the Philippine government stopped us from operating due to the perception of the roadworthiness of motorcycles. After 6 years, we were shut down 4 times, 3 by the government and once by COVID. But we worked hard and invested in our partner riders. Our training earned us a 99.997% safety rating, demonstrating that when Filipinos receive the proper safety training and assessment, they thrive and become better drivers, providing a model for others to follow. Most Filipino startups and business owners demonstrate a passion for learning, which is a quality that is vital if you want to succeed in any career. We should also be humble enough and willing to fill those knowledge gaps by learning more. The road to success has a lot of roadblocks, and the journey to a thriving business will not be easy. However, a lot of Filipino entrepreneurs have proven that experience, along with a strong work ethic and tenacity, is the best way to move forward. I want you to imagine a future you believe in and do your part to turn it into a reality. Our society is constantly faced with a plethora of problems, and it is your responsibility to solve them by bringing about change with the help of your platform. It may appear that problems are endless, but do you know what else is endless? Your will and determination. Keep in mind that the sun will always rise tomorrow, which means that every other waking moment is an opportunity to grow as a person, as a leader, and as a member of the community.
Congratulations to the CEO of ANCAS, George Royeca.
I have always wanted to be my own boss. I am motivated by a sense of responsibility towards those under our employ. And I am inspired and excited by creating innovative products that delight our customers. The pandemic caused a lot of disruptions in our conduct of business. In order to overcome, we applied practical measures to address the root cause. Since work stoppage due to COVID infection was a major threat, plant workers were housed in designated staff houses and provided with their daily needs. The decrease in product demand due to lockdowns was also a major concern. However, we were prepared with facilities to store and process these inventories into other products. Filipinos are very service-oriented, which is a very good quality to possess, since service is integral to most, if not all, businesses. In order for the business to operate successfully, you need to devote time and effort. To expand, you should know how to delegate. To succeed, you should train successors and know when to let go. And most importantly, always set a goal. The moment we stop reaching for a goal is the moment we start deteriorating.
Ms. Aileen Y. Sui, COO of Anna's Breeders Farms Incorporated, is our next finalist. Congratulations.
As one of the first e-commerce enablers in the country, what motivates me is the drive to leave an impact on my generation and on future generations to come, to be an example of what you can achieve once you let go of the uncertainties and embrace the limitless possibilities. Most of all, I want to uplift Filipino lives and to enable dreams in the digital economy. The early days of the COVID pandemic tested the company in a way we never expected. Navigating the new normal was challenging. Simply surviving was not enough. We had to adapt and find new ways to thrive, regardless of the circumstances. And it required a lot of teamwork and communications. The ability to maintain a positive outlook, no matter what the odd is, in my opinion, is our best quality. We take every setback as a blessing to learn and to adapt. We do our best to prepare for anything, to try to foresee all possible outcomes, especially the worst ones. But that never discourages us to remain hopeful of the future. The best advice I can give is to start small and to start now. A lot of us are so afraid of uncertainty, so afraid to fail that we just stop completely. Becoming a successful entrepreneur doesn't happen immediately. It's a process of making mistakes and learning from those mistakes. So, whatever skill or idea you have, no matter how small, keep working at it.
Dave C., CEO and founder of Great Deals E-Commerce Corporation.
My main source of inspiration is in leadership, and I have learned that transformation will not take hold without the right team, believers and builders that every entrepreneur needs. Together with these teams, the entrepreneur inspires confidence in the business that it is viable and in people's potential to pursue and persevere along the path of transformation. The pandemic and the resulting challenges are the most significant disruption I personally experience, and that of the companies under the MFT Group. In hindsight, the disruption was an opportunity to recalibrate and make the most of what was left functioning amidst the lockdowns and precautions. For MFT Group, our well-intentioned strategy of diversification in both defensive and offensive sectors provided a cushion against the heavy blows. Most importantly, we manage the disruption by standing by each other. I am proud to say, employee layoff was never even considered. The identity of a Filipino entrepreneur, or entrepinoy, is rooted in the collective values of her community and her personal values. I believe her qualities are marked by three R's: resourcefulness, resilience, and responsibility. Do not be afraid to fail, and believe in bouncing back. Both in your career and personal life, you will encounter setbacks, and you will find yourself standing back up again. Know in your heart of hearts that the bigger the challenge, the bigger the win. You lead others to find work with which human dignity flourishes. You stoke innovation that uplifts the life of others. And you inspire positive change that makes life worth living.
Maria Francesca Tan, CEO, MFT Group of Companies. Congratulations.
Technology changed people's life is what inspired me. Right now, Converge is bringing connectivity to millions of households, even remote towns and barangays. It is my job to make sure this technology reaches them because it is their right. When the pandemic hit, Filipinos were quarantined at home and were in need of really fast and really strong internet connection. We were here to serve that need, but the demand exploded by 4 times. Everybody was getting a fiber connection, so that compelled us to adapt. We got more linemen, more customer service agent, more personnel to meet the demand. We were able to give them a solution through high speed, high capacity, and reliable broadband internet. Filipino entrepreneurs are always thinking about how they can help others. There is always a social aspect to Filipino entrepreneurs. Perhaps it is because we live in a difficult environment, so our motivation is always how to make things easier for our fellow Filipinos. Filipino entrepreneurs are creative, resourceful, and resilient. Even though they encounter hardship, they are able to overcome and adapt quickly. Find your why. In my opinion, a successful businessman is one with a clear calling. Converge exists because I truly believe that it is every Filipino right to have access fast and stable connectivity. To other entrepreneurs, know that your purpose will determine your direction. So I encourage you to find your why and always be the first to believe in it.
Dennis Anthony Uy, Chief Executive Officer and Co-Founder of Converge ICT Solutions Incorporated.
I was a son of a lowly and marginalized fisherman, the sixth among the 12 children, and we were always not sure where to get our next meal. I learned that a lot of Chinese nationals came to the Philippines, particularly in Cebu. They started small business to buy and sell household items in our old carbon market. But a few decades later, they became multi-billion business conglomerates. This greatly inspires me because if he can do it, why can't we? The most significant disruption we experienced happened in the mid-1990s when after serving Philfos fertilizer for more than 5 years, we began to serve their logistics requirement on power supplies and equipment from Cebu office to Isabelete plant. However, our being frugal, hardworking, and devoted pulled us up and we started to approach other prospective clients. Thanks be to God, we were gifted with new big clients like PNOC, NPC, Abuitis Metafil, Mansteel, and many more. For me, the best qualities of a Filipino entrepreneur should be honesty, being friendly, and frugality. However, some other traits that could be beneficial to our business are also being hard worker, enthusiastic, flexible, and always being ready to accept failures. Be vigilant. Involve your wife in business because, as the saying goes, behind every successful man, there stands a woman. The strong and godly sincere support of our wife could lead us to great business partnerships. Lastly, we must learn how to give back. Because the more that we share, the more that God's blessing will overflow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Antonio Enoch, Founder and Chief Executive Officer, Prime Movers Total Logistics Incorporated. Our 18 finalists this year are role models of successful entrepreneurship indeed. After all, they've more than just created value and profits for their own companies, but most importantly, they've also helped uplift their employees. And in the process, as one of their main objectives for being in their business, to help uplift the country as well and help develop the economy. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to proceed to the awarding of our winners for 2022. We have six award categories. We have, among these six awards, we have an award for Young Entrepreneur, Technology Entrepreneur, Small Business Entrepreneur, Woman Entrepreneur, Emerging Entrepreneur, and of course, Master Entrepreneur. Our Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines 2022 will emerge from these six category winners. And the country winner will represent the Philippines, our country, in the World Entrepreneur of the Year Awards, which will be held in Monte Carlo, Monaco next year in June. That's June 2023.
EY World Entrepreneur of the Year is the ultimate global competition for entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs that are reinventing industries, revitalizing economies, and reimagining a new era of diversity, sustainability, and prosperity. each making a world of difference. Winners of years past are founders, leaders, and all-round visionaries whose endeavors have built a better working world. They are pioneers who've asked better questions to get better answers. This year in Monaco, delegates came together to celebrate the power of entrepreneurship. Celebrating 50 winners from 41 countries and jurisdictions.
Welcome to the EY World Entrepreneur of the Year Award 2022.
Recognizing one individual who has raised the bar in sustainability.
A big round of applause for Stella McCartney.
And crowning the 2022 winner of EY World Entrepreneur of the Year.
The 2022 EY World Entrepreneur of the Year is Gaston Taratuda from Argentina.
Because one person can make a world of difference. Find out how EY supports entrepreneurs in realizing their bold ambitions.
Let's proceed now to the announcement of the category winners. The Young Entrepreneur Award is given to an entrepreneur who is 35 years old or younger, who has shown exemplary management over a sustained period of time, making him or her an inspiration and role model to the youth. Our young entrepreneur for 2022 is none other than Leandro Antonio Leviste, Chief Executive Officer and President of Solar Philippines Power Project Holdings Incorporated. This award aims to recognize an outstanding entrepreneur who has innovatively leveraged technology to transform and enhance the delivery of products and services to customers, to grow the business, and of course, to create a positive impact on their stakeholders and on the technology community. Our Technology Entrepreneur of the Year, and he is Steve S. C., Chief Executive Officer of Great Deals E-Commerce Corporation. Please join us on stage to receive your award, Mr. C. Small Business Entrepreneur Award is given to an entrepreneur for best demonstrating management in excellence in a business with total assets not exceeding 100 million pesos. Now, the small business entrepreneur is Mr. Francisco Magsaysay, Chief Executive Officer of Carmen's Best Dairy Products Incorporated. Congratulations. This award aims to recognize the outstanding contributions of women in entrepreneurship and leadership. Our woman entrepreneur for 2022 is Ms. Lisette A. Laos Velasco, Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of Global Cars Philippines Incorporated. Congratulations, Lisette. Emerging Entrepreneur Category Award is given to the entrepreneur who has applied sound management practices and exceptional leadership to building an enterprise with vast potential for future growth and future expansion. Now, this individual's business assets, excluding land, of course, must be more than 100 million pesos, but less than 1 billion pesos. And his company or her company must have been founded at least 2 years ago. Our emerging entrepreneur for 2022 is George Royeca, Chief Executive Officer of Angkas. The Master Entrepreneur Award is given to the entrepreneur who best exemplifies sound management practices in critical areas of the company, including finance, marketing, human resources, and sales. The recipient possesses the highest set of company values and a strong relationship with employees, with customers, with suppliers and shareholders, and of course, the communities where their businesses operate. Our Master Entrepreneur for 2022 is none other than Dennis Anthony Uy, Chief Executive Officer and Co-Founder of Converge ICT Solutions Incorporated. So we've come to the most awaited part of the night, the announcement of the Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines 2022. The Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines is the consummate entrepreneur, the embodiment of the entrepreneurial values of leadership, of team building, of innovational and financial performance, and of course, most importantly, social transformation. Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines 2022 is presented to Dennis Anthony Uy, CEO and co-founder of Converge ICT Solutions Incorporated. Mr. Dennis Anthony Uy is presented with our Entrepreneur of the Year Award for his passion for technology, his desire to bring internet connectivity to Filipinos, and his visionary ability to stay ahead of the competition. Dennis had the foresight to invest in fiber optics and micro-trenching while the industry was still using older technologies, leading to Converge being one of the first to offer fiber-to-the-home fixed broadband services in the Philippines. Once again, Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines 2022 is presented to Dennis Anthony Uy. Thank you so much for supporting our Undaunted and our unstoppable Filipino entrepreneurs who thrive in the age of disruption and lead enterprises that inspire and empower communities for a better Philippines. Again, we wish our Entrepreneur of the Year Philippines 2022, Dennis Anthony Uy, all the best as he vies for the World Entrepreneur of the Year Awards next year in Monte Carlo, Monaco. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been your host, David Saldran. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.